Hey guys, Ilya here, and this time we are in Panzerwagen in Ansk. You don't see me in Ansk very often because there is usually nothing interesting to show, but this time I'm playing full HE because Panzerwagen has fantastic 120mm of penetration. You see, my claim is that 120mm of penetration with high explosive is enough for a tier 10 tank. Well, okay, maybe a little bit too low, 150 would be perfect, but it's usually enough, at least against tier 8 and tier 9 tanks, because of the mechanics of high explosives. You see, the armoring of the tanks consists of two main parts. It's the thickness of armor itself, obviously, and it's the slope of the armor. Because we have Type 5 Heavy as an example of thickness, you know, it's vertical, but it's very thick. And we have STRV as the example of the opposite case, where we have very thin armor, but it's really well angled and also tends to bounce stuff off if it's not of too high caliber. And we have like Mouse as an example of both, right? So high explosives don't care about the angle of armor. So you hit the enemy with your high explosive and then you just ask, do you have 120 there? Yes or no? If yes, that's a penetration. And trust me, not many tanks have more than 120 penetration somewhere. At least not mediums or lights, of course. Or tank destroyers. Because Object 140 has only 100mm in the front, so you can actually shoot the upper plate of Object 140 and penetrate it with a high explosive of Panzerwagen. So you really, all you need to do is to aim really carefully at the enemy to make sure that you're hitting the weaker part of the enemy. Because you don't just shoot the side of the enemy, you try to shoot the upper part of the side, above the tracks. And if you do all of that careful aiming, then you have a chance for a lot higher damage. Like, you'll get 420 average instead of 320. So you buff your DPM by more than a quarter, and you actually become very dangerous. And then, you know, even if you don't ban, you can always shoot tracks and knock down the tracks very easily, because in case of high explosives, you don't even need to hit the track itself, you know, to hit it precisely. Even if the RNG says, like, no, you're not gonna hit the track, and you just hit the enemy next to the track, the splash will do the rest, and you'll still keep the enemy tracked. And, you know, tracking enemy at the right moment can also be very, very effective. So I would say that after I started to use a lot of high explosives in Panzerwagen, well, maybe I started to deal a little bit less damage, a little bit, not so much, because, you know, you still penetrate enemies pretty often, but I can assist a lot better, and actually I get so much fun, because, you know, every time you penetrate enemy with high explosive, not a PCR, not heat, but high explosive, it feels like, I don't know, there is something special about penetrating enemy with high explosive. Every time, regardless of the tank, I would say. So here you could see that I was aiming at some weaker parts of the enemy, sometimes, you know, the upper part of the side or just the turret of some enemy. And then I got quite a few penetrations. Well, yeah, tier 8 tanks, but same works for tier 9 tanks. And again, it's a bit trickier for tier 10s, but still doable. So if you have Panzerwagen, then give it a try and try assisting, try destroying tracks, and it will be a lot of fun. And there we go, it's almost 8k in Ansk, which is probably my best ever result in this map. So thank you for watching, guys. I hope this video was interesting for you, and then see you next time.